You know, when this stuff all happened, I'm like, man, I'm bummed because I had like a better progression this year. You know, like I was building slow and really starting to put it up there and fish for those top spots. So I was bummed because I put a lot of work into that slow build and that, you know, that just kind of ease into it type of deal. I felt fresh and like I felt like I was ready to ramp it. So when I got the news, I was kind of bummed, but at the same time, dude, I'm so like, I got so many other things going on and so many, you know, little things that I dig doing and things I needed to be doing too. So I just, I worked on my house, in North Carolina a little bit, did some home improvement stuff, and my place needed an AC and it needed, you know, trim and this and that, and I re-roofed this and that, you know, just a bunch of little things like that. And then after that, I went home to Oregon and worked on this shop that we got going up and did a little studio work, like kind of enjoyed the time. Like it went by like that, like it was 7-8 weeks, but I'm like, feels like we were just kind of racing yesterday. So when I got the call, I mean, I actually took up golfing a little bit though, like with my girl's family, and you know, they did golfing, so I'm always over there hanging out with them, golfing and stuff. So I actually got the news. I was out on the course, like just having a ball, like, you know, every day was a day off at that point. So I'm like, took a day from working on stuff and went golfing, and we played 45 holes, and we got done golfing, and dude, it was a blast. But I was just completely just like. And I go and I pick my phone up and I'm like, had like 35 messages, like all this stuff about the race is back on and this and that. And I'm like, oh, okay. So grabbed a flight and came back. But who knows, man? Who knows if it's going to happen? But I'm here. I like riding. I miss riding, you know? So it's like some guys might be a little frustrated, like with what's going on and what's, you know, like this unsurety and some guys kind of almost have to have this date, and they set their minds on it, and it's like that's how they, you know, they make it happen. But I'm like, dude, I just like riding, and I like random stuff, you know. So I think it's going to actually come into my hand a little bit if it happens. So hopefully it does happen. It'd be good for us, but just get it over with too, because then I want to go back to what I was doing. So I want to get done, get out of the way. I was hoping that it was just going to, we were going to get that consistent 17 rounds in and call it a day. And I was looking forward to that actually. And you know, hopefully it happens. We'll see. So originally the messages that I got from the team, which, you know, they talked to Feld and they got kind of the gist and some parameters of how we would do it. Mainly it was more like, hey, we're going to go to Phoenix. We're going to race 7 times. It's going to be in this time period. You know, this and this and this and that has to all happen for the government to allow it. You know, that like a lot of the, hey, this is, could be still a problem was included in that. So it was like, all right, what do you guys want to do? Kind of a thing. And I gave my opinion. I'm like, hey, if we can do it, let's do it. So, but what it included was basically a start date of May 15th and an end date of June 15th. And we were just going to jam it all in those 4 weeks. Obviously that's changed. We really don't know we don't know if that date was solid. We don't know if this one's solid. We don't know if September blah, blah, blah is solid. I mean, we really don't, with what's going on in the world right now. It's so goofy. It's just like, be ready but not be like frustrated or burned out or well, they wanted to keep it on everybody's mind, like, oh, there's a possibility we'll go racing, which in a way it's like, it's almost kind of a bummer from like rate from the racer perspective, because we're like, we're so used to having, oh, we have 6 weeks off here, you know, so let's take our time, you know. And this was going to be one of those, you know, because we didn't really have a choice or anything like that. So we just, you know, we were told, hey, we can't race no more. I drove to Indy, showed up, and place was empty, and looked like the beginning of Walking Dead. It was just goofy, and then they said he can't race no more. So I'm like, okay, you know, I'll go do some stuff, and you know, I'll you know wait for it to come around. But the unsurety and the waffling and fickle attitude of what is, you know, what the promoters are at right now, which it's not like it's a shock or it's not understandable. They're in a position as we all are,
their
you know.
Hands are tied, yeah.
Well, their hands are tied from a lot of angles, but they're also feel that they have obligations to feel that this needs to continue.
Right.
There has to be a conclusion to this series. If it wasn't so close, if it wasn't a 1-point split between Eli and Kenny, they probably would have called it. In my opinion, it's not like putting yourself at risk or anything like that. It was just basically like, oh, we're not racing until September. So the team said, okay, we're going to reset and we're going to, you know, treat it like the next season pretty much. Like, okay, you guys get your time now and we come back here. But, you know, my mistake is I don't just go and say, hey, I want a bike that's mine, like my title to it, so that I can ride it at any point and be anywhere with it, wherever I want to be. And that's kind of like, I mean, it's easier said than done, you know, sometimes. I mean, bikes are $10,000, so it's like, it's not like you're just getting chucked motorcycles and equipment like you did back in 07. So it's, you know, it's just a little bit different. But, you know, if I would have had that, I mean, I was at my place in Oregon, I got tracks everywhere, you know, so it's like, if I had a bike, I'd have been riding for sure. But, it's more like, once you have, you know, this bike, or, you know, a factory team, and you're on it like we are now, it's like, you don't really want to go ride a stock bike. I mean, unless you're doing something else, but towards the thing that you're wanting to go race, it's like, I think it's good if you're trying to learn what that motorcycle is. Like, if you're trying to go, what does a Honda do? Go ride a stock one. Like, well, that's what it does out of the box. What does ours do? You know, so there's that. But I mean, I'd have for sure been riding. I'm not trying to act like I wouldn't be, but that's just how it shake down, you know. I just think it's healthy as a human being to not be so consumed with one thing, because, you know, if that one thing doesn't go your way, that can really cut you down at the ankles. And I feel like, you know, I could, the ability to kind of take or leave this at certain points kind of gives me a bit more long-term motivation with it, if you will. So yeah, time like this, I'm not stressing. I mean, I'm kind of never stressing, but times like this, I'm like, you know, is okay. I got into the studio just a little bit, but I was busy just working on stuff and constructing things and doing stuff that was like, yeah, this has been kind of sitting out for this long and, you know, it needs to be addressed, you know? So, you know, it wasn't like I'm like, oh, thank God racing's over so I can go, you know, it wasn't like that at all. Like I was bummed when I got the news, because, you know, just because it's not like you put months and months and months of effort and thought into what you're doing and then you want it to just not conclude, you know. So I really was looking forward to it being a good end, and like I kept saying it, I'm like, somebody's hell bent on me not getting 17 clean rounds in or something, because it's like, man, every time I get close, something weird happens. But if the seven rounds go through and we do it in Phoenix, I think I should be right back where I was. I mean, I just did 20 laps with the guys, and I mean, I haven't rode since Daytona. But you know, I keep in shape and I enjoy working out. I don't touch any sort of like upper body or weights or anything like that. I'll blow up. I'll get really heavy. So when I'm working out, it's like for the sport, you know, and it's like, if I work out any other way, which I like to work out a lot of other ways that are fun to me. But if I do that, it's like very counteractive to riding, and you know, it's not really like, you don't want to be a muscly beast that can't quite move or have the dexterity and the hand-eye coordination and everything. You know, it's not really an efficient way to be. So that's the type of stuff that I have to like hold back from doing, you know. Like if I was done racing and I knew it for sure, dude, you'd see me in a couple months just I just no knack anymore. Like that's the type of stuff like I would like, and you know, and I've always done a little bit of sparring here and there, and I really love the fight game. I've always wanted to get into grappling and all that sort of stuff. But all that I've done ever is like kind of set me back on the bike. And it's like my favorite stuff to do that's active and it would keep you in shape. But it's like, I have to be like, no, not right now, not yet. Like, so, yeah, so there could be 15 things, but I only did 9.